part of our movement of love and connection. And just to give you a little background on who we are, why we're sitting here together, hanging out, having a good time on a Wednesday night. My name is Laura, and this is Heather, Jenna, Tan, Monica, Christy, and Marissa. We started this group 9 months ago in my living room, our living room, Heather lives with me, with an intention, to bring women in our community together and to uplift each other and to teach each other how to love ourselves more so we can go out into the community to really take over the world together, you guys. So we are on a mission. Our mission statement is that we are a tribe of open, authentic, fearless women who are on a mission to evoke our deepest desires and empower women to be leaders of their own lives. And we're on a mission to do that with ourselves and to hopefully, through conversation with each other, spark something inside of you so you can go out and do it for your community and we can change the world together. So our group is called We Change the World. Women's Empowerment Changes the World. We truly believe that. And my good friend Tan actually had a vision of this group. Was it 2 years ago, Tan?
2 years ago.
2 years ago, before we even started. And I want you to, can you share your...
Okay, great. Hi, my name is Tan. Briefly, I was a social worker, burned out, tired of the politics, but I absolutely loved my clients. Kind of moved from that into massage therapy where I could actually put my energy to use, be able to share my love and passion for people on the table. And that kind of pushed me into currently doing health and wellness. Well, 2 years ago, I was actually in a store and was pushing a shopping cart. There was a lady in front of me who had, it was during Christmas time, so she had a cart full of plates and dishes and things, and it was obviously she was going to set her table up for Christmas, and it was just weird. I felt this feeling come over me, and instantly I just like heard this voice say, you're going to do a women's empowerment group, and they're going to bring mugs to you, and you're going to fill them. Well, I had no idea. I just said, okay, I'm good. Let's do it. Kind of just left it there and just figured if it's a vision that's given to me, then it's definitely going to play out, and I would definitely just be available for it to happen. So pretty much roll the tape for 2 years. I became a health and wellness coach, met these amazing women, and shared my vision, ended up at an empowerment group here, and here we are. So it's just completely unfolded. When you talk about speaking things into existence and just the law of attraction is a big, big deal. And just what we believe we can do completely. If you believe in your heart, you can completely grab a hold to anything you absolutely want to do and bring it into your space and make it happen. So I just want to go ahead and pass it off to my amazing friend Monica over here. She has just been a solid piece of amazing love in my life, and I just want to just have her share some information about her. Just
thank you, Tan.
You're welcome.
I'm a mirror reflection. So, my name is Monica, and I'm the founder of the Next Level Program. I have a master's in spiritual psychology, and the Next Level Program uses some of my skills in psychology as well as my life experiences, both positive, negative, trauma, happy, joy, and hardship, combining them all together and really allowing all the juicy bits that encourage who we are and allow us to be ourselves to be expressed and to have a forum where people feel safe to do that. And what I love is that I get to be part of something extraordinary, that we each are individuals, but we're all part of something amazing together, and that I'm a mommy of a little boy, a little girl, and another little girl, and I get to show them how to express themselves every day of their lives. So I'm thrilled to be here. I love every second of this. And I want to pass it off to Jenna, who's extraordinary. Power. She wears the most beautiful I Am hat, which is going to be such a big foundation of part of tonight, what we're going to share with you. So, Jenna, I'm excited to introduce you to everybody.
Hello. My name is Jenna Phillips. I'm the founder of I'm on a Mission. And the reason why I founded my company is because I was in a head trauma accident and diagnosed with type 1 diabetes 13 years ago, given a second chance at life. And so my vision and my purpose is to motivate and inspire people to take ownership of who they truly are and use these powerful words, I am, to create the reality that they want and know that nothing is off limits to them and they can create anything that they want in their life just by stating, declaring who they are and living that truth every single day. So the only thing that's going to get in your way of everything that you want is limiting belief you have about yourself. So I show people how to break through that and just be leaders of their own lives. And here I am. And I'm going to pass on to my amazing friend, Ms. Heather, over here. Love
sick.
Her. Yeah. Yeah, sexy. She's sexy.
My mug actually says sexy, but I think you can only see the first three letters on camera, so, you know, I like to keep it interesting. My name is Heather, and I actually started Team Sexy almost 2 years ago, and my background is I played volleyball my entire life. I played at UCLA, and I actually retired and went into corporate America, gained a bunch of weight, had an office body, was just unhealthy and unhappy, and my amazing friend Laura actually helped me go on my journey to getting in the best shape of my life and really getting my life back and my confidence back, and that's really what manifested Team Sexy. And you know, it's really my passion now. I've since left corporate America, and I'm a full-time health and wellness coach. You know, we run a nutrition and fitness business together, and I'm following my passion, and I get to design my life. And it all started with a risk that I took on myself. And limiting beliefs are incredible. We're going to talk about it, and I've really transformed my entire life and what I thought about my life. And, you know, Team Sexy transpired out of it, and it's my intention to really be the space for people to do that in their own life and to step into their power. So, super excited to be here with you guys and this group of incredible leaders and women and sexy women. We're just really happy to have you here. So I'm actually going to pass it off to the beautiful Christy Fernandez to tell our story.
Yes, hello. What a blessing to be here and to share this space with each and every one of you out there. My name is Christy Fernandez. I am the founder of Inspira Lifestyle. And in my former life, I worked in banking for 9 years. In Manhattan, and it was something that I thought I needed to do because I grew up very poor, and I did not want that for my life. That was not the vision that I wanted for myself. And in chasing someone else's dream for myself, I realized where it left me. And so I took really the other side, and I got into fitness, nutrition, and self-development. And in healing myself and in finding my passion, I've been able to do that for the world, and it's been one of the greatest gifts I've been able to give myself and to this planet. So Inspira Lifestyle has been my healing, and I hope that I can share that with each and every one of you. I am extremely excited to pass it on to an amazing woman, I'm gonna say, and she has just been such an inspiration and such a blessing on so many levels. I wanna pass it over to Laura Holloway.
So my name is Laura, and I was an athlete my entire life. I played every sport, ended up deciding to play college volleyball. And after I played in college, I actually became an entrepreneur. I'm a health and fitness coach with a few of these girls. And I really found that through what I do, I get to be the best version of myself, and I get to do something for me for the first time in my life. And, you know, through winning national championships and through, you know, making a lot of money and doing really awesome things in my life, I never felt fulfilled ever. I was always like, great, what's next? Great, what's next? Great, what's next? And this is the first time ever in my life that I've done something for me because I started to really love myself. I started to love what I was doing. I started to love the impact that I was making. And all I want to do now from this point in my life moving forward is share that with other people and share that joy and help people understand that joy is never going to come from anyone else outside of you. So I'm so glad I found that out at 26 years old. Thank God. But I'm really excited for Marissa to share her beautiful story, and then we can get into our topic for today.
My name is Marissa O'Neill. Similar to Laura, I was an athlete my entire life. So I grew up in the health and wellness space and ended my college athletic career as a freshman. My body completely broke down. And I had to learn how to heal my body, sort of body, mind, and soul, as they're all interconnected. And what I've done since a freshman in college is dedicated my life to learning how to heal my body and then how to empower other people to heal theirs in return. So I recently climbed the corporate ladder, learned that wasn't fulfilling, learned that it was all about money and it wasn't about helping people, and I love helping people, inspiring them, empowering them to be the best version of themselves. So I recently left corporate America the end of 2012, and I am now working for myself. I'm writing books and empowering people to heal their bodies. So I'm really happy to be part of this group.
I love it. So Monica is actually going to lead our topic for today, and really it's discussion. So we're going to be sharing with each other some things that we've discovered throughout our life. And then hopefully while we're talking, something will come up for you and you're going to have some self-realization. So Monica, would you mind introing our topic?
My pleasure. So a topic that's very near and dear to my heart. So there are some things on the planet that we get born into and they become gifts if we choose to look at them that way. And so I would say that one of the gifts that I was blessed with is really being able to hear what people say underneath what they're really, the words that they're speaking out loud. And some of what that gift allows me to do is really support people in uncovering what it is that stops them in their life. So tonight you have an opportunity as you engage in this conversation with us, and maybe you're sitting with someone, or maybe you simply want to just grab a notebook or a piece of paper and have a pen and just write down whatever thoughts, whatever ideas, whatever things you feel might have stopped you in your life. And the reason that's so powerful is when we begin to look at the things in our life that we feel stop us today, yesterday, last week, we can begin to track that back into the past. And there were times in our life where things like that affected us when we were very young, but we didn't have the resources, the tools, the awareness, the experiences to be able to draw upon what it is that we needed at the time to be able to be okay, to know that we were safe, to know that we were still loved, to know that we were still valuable. And so what we did is very often we made a decision about how to avoid the hurt, the sadness, the feeling or expression that we felt was limited or felt stopped us in some way. So tonight we want to discuss, this morning, as you know, we have a women's empowerment group that gets to meet in person. And this morning when we were discussing it, we got to be led through a visualization. And in that visualization, I really invited people to start with whatever was a triggering event or an experience that they had in the past week that disturbed their peace in some way. And then we traced that back in time to an earlier time in their life that maybe you had experienced something like that before. And in so doing, we got to understand that that was something we made up. It was a decision, it was a belief based on something that we decided with all the resources that we had at that time. So now, knowing that, we can recreate our experience. We can create a brand new belief and transform that old belief. And then all there is to do is every day practice operating, sharing, and being inside of that new belief. And just like if you were to go to a gym and build a muscle, you can actually recreate this new belief as what your life is built on. And from that place, you can really uncover new things, you can invite new experiences, and you can break through anything that was in the past that stopped you and create from nothing whatever it is that you want. So tonight, we're going to just share both with you and invite you to also reflect on this as we are sharing. What are some of those things in your life that stopped you? And I shared this morning, it has this really neat domino effect where once you uncover one thing, very often when you begin to heal that one thing, it can have the domino effect and heal so many other things in our life because we shed this new light, like a flashlight in the dark little corners of our lives that allow us to really embrace, oh, I made that decision up and now I have a whole new way to make new choices and operate from a new place. So to start, if it's okay, I'll start with my limiting belief.
Yes.
Okay, good. So in my life, there's been a lot of times where I have felt really different. I've felt like I've had a different opinion or a different thought or a different experience than other people. And so when I've done that, when I share with people, I felt alienated. I felt like they've judged me, or I felt like I don't fit in, I don't belong. And what I would do as a result of that is I would hide, or I would pretend, or I would completely overcompensate. So for many years of my life, it was, you know, I had to be right. And I just loved experiencing with people, you know, let me tell you why, and this is how it is. And, you know, you can imagine how fun it is to have a conversation with someone who's right all the time. Like, I really know what you're saying, but no, oh, no, yeah, I have all the answers for you. And over time, what it did is it actually alienated me. So the very thing I wanted to do on the planet, which was to spread love and love people, it started keeping me separate and separate and separate. So as I started identifying this morning, one of the things that came forward for me is that the cost that it has is it kept me alone. Now, there was benefits to being alone, because in the aloneness, I really had to start and reflect, how do I love myself? How do I get to be with me? And by reflecting on that, I got to develop, what does it actually take to love myself? Where do I have to be vulnerable? Where do I have to listen better? what kinds of questions do I have to ask instead of having answers? Because it was me asking me those questions. So by revealing that and seeing that that was really my cost, it was like, okay, now I can make all new choices. So my transformed belief is that I am unlimited prosperity, and I'm inviting love on the planet in all my interactions and in all my conversations. So it gives me the opportunity to express really truly what I'm here to do, and gives you permission to see it for yourself and recognize how to express from that place.
Wow.
And
I love it.
Yes!
Wow. Love it.
And I love it.
And I love it. Yeah. So
powerful.
That's, yeah.
Thanks.
I love
how
you said we could create something from nothing, and it's just, mm-hmm. just so powerful.
Well, and what's been so neat about it is, you know, as I said, I'm a mom of three kids. So one of the things I want to gift my children with is the opportunity to really see that they have what they need, and that in conversations where someone may provide their opinion,
yeah.
because children sometimes don't have that filter to be able to be necessarily appropriate, they're really in truth, that my children don't take it on as that it's their truth.
Mm-hmm.
You can tell me what you feel, but it doesn't have to be my truth.
Mm-hmm.
And if I can walk that on the planet and my children can embrace that, what a gift
wow.
that I've given to them.
Huge.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's beautiful. And the power in that lies within the fact that you're able to acknowledge that and share that and so humbly say, you know, of course, acknowledge the gifts that you have and own them. I mean, that's amazing.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
I just find, I literally, like, there are so many times where people are like, you know, what are your limiting beliefs? Like, I've done workshops and I felt like I could never, like, find it. Like, they're like, go back to your childhood when you're like from 3 to 5 years old, and then 5 to 8, and I'd be like, I don't see anything. Like, I'd be like, what am I supposed to, like, is something supposed to come? Like, and I was really trying to be open. And I actually, this past January, was doing an event, and I was speaking with someone in the back of the room, and he, just through a conversation, my limiting belief popped.
Mm-hmm.
And literally in that moment, I started bawling crying because I realized that I had been operating inside of something. I was 7 years old, and I'll share with you guys, I was on the soccer field, and I was a good athlete. I played a lot of different sports. My dad happened to be my coach, and my dad was my hero, and Jenna has a similar story, but my dad was my hero, and I was a goofy little kid. I'm talking, like everything, like, out there, like, come on, team! Like, I was, like, a mascot, okay? I was, like, the team mascot, okay? And my dad pulled me, he's like, time out, he's like, baby, like, we gotta win this game. And I was like, okay, we gotta win this game. So I went on, we scored 7 goals, and we won. And from that moment on, obviously, after we won, I got a lot of love. But I realized, number one, what I was capable of. I can turn it on and win in any moment. And in return, the payoff is that I get love. So I realized I was operating for someone else, though. I started winning my entire life, like winning national championships, player of the year, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And it was just like I was operating for other people to get love when it wasn't even my authentic self. And I got that, but then this man that was talking to me in January said, let me reframe that. He's like, when you have success, you get love, but in order to have success, you have to be serious. And I just started bawling. I was like, I do have to be serious. And I'm a goofy little kid. And I'm goofy, Lord. And so my transformed belief is that we can make an impact on the planet. We can have endless abundance, tons of money. We can contribute. I can contribute to the world. And it can be fun. It can be simple. It can be goofy. It can be playful. And it doesn't have to be serious. But it is, I do have the depth to get serious, but I get to choose.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and for me to have awareness like that, it showed up in volleyball, it showed up in my whole life. I was looking at experiences and, like, now running my own business, and now that I have that awareness, I'm like, I'm so excited. I'm like, I can do business like this.
We can have fun.
And we can have fun. So thanks for letting me share that with
you
guys.
Awesome. Love you. I'm going to kind of piggyback on her story because I have a very similar experience. When I was about 7, I, at the time, had this belief that my dad wanted to have a son for his firstborn. I was the firstborn, so I was always trying to be this star athlete for him because
wanted to play with Barbies and wear pink dresses and play in the dirt, climb trees and, like, you know, do the whole thing. That was what I wanted to do, but I was trying to excel as an athlete, even though my heart wasn't in it. And there was this one day, my dad was my soccer coach, and I was out there kind of just messing around, not really taking the game seriously, because I really didn't want to be there for the right reasons. And he pulled me off the field, and I will never forget this because my dad was my hero, this big, huge guy, and I'm looking up at my dad, and he's looking down on me and saying, "You're not doing enough out there. You're not playing hard enough. You're not kicking the ball. You're not even trying to take any, you know, make any goals. Like, what are you doing? Like, why are you even out there?" And my whole everything just crumbled, and I just felt in that moment that I wasn't enough, and no matter what, I will never be able to live up to my dad's standards or make him proud. So I adapted that belief, and it showed up in every avenue of my life. So that head conversation of you're not enough, like no matter how much you do, and I've had a very successful career. I've traveled all over the world. I started my company when I was 23, 24 years old, and tons of press. Like, I mean, I could go on and on forever about the kind of career that I've had, the kind of people that I've worked with, and what I've accomplished. And I would always write my dad Christmas cards, birthday cards, and I would always say, and I didn't even realize this, I would always say, "I just want to make you proud, Dad. I'm sorry I can't see you as often as I, you know, want to, but I'm just working hard. I just want to make you proud." And he would always say that. And so he would always say it to me, like, you do make me proud. But I still, even though he would say it, I still didn't believe it. And, you know, recently what's come up for me is my business is now taking on a whole new direction. These hats are flying out of my hands like crazy. I can't even keep up with the orders, which is amazing, a beautiful blessing to have. So my limiting belief showed up, like, you're not doing enough, you can't keep it together, like, there's too much going on, you can't handle it all by yourself. And I go, this is my new transform belief.
Get excited, because I'm excited.
Get ready, kids. I decided that I'm doing more than enough. I'm kicking ass, I'm doing awesome, and it's perfectly okay to ask for support. So I'm putting out in the universe that I'm looking for a personal assistant who's amazing and awesome and ready to kick ass with me as this company grows and expands and takes over the world.
Ugh. Wow.
Done.
Oh.
Yeah. And what I love about that, Jenna, is when you declare something like that and you share it with the world and you know the people that know that they're supposed to be with you and that they have that vision and they see something amazing for themselves, hook up with it.
It's always true.
And it's so attractive. Mm-hmm. And I love, you know, this whole topic. When we transform limiting beliefs, we become manifestors. Mm-hmm. We become intuitive. We become attractive. So things just start coming. So, you know, transform those limiting beliefs.
I want to put you in my pocket and take you everywhere.
We're going to make a Monica, like bear where you, like, push it. And it's like,
yeah.
What's your transformation for the day? How are you loving yourself? I was like, forget the bear. Let's make an app.
Yeah, there you go.
By the way, you guys, if you guys have comments that you want to share or questions that you want to ask, we have our operations manager, Madison, who we have a
phone
here.
Madison!
Let us know if you'll answer any questions that you have. So, yeah.
That's why we're on the phone.
Who wants to share?
Great. I'll share.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so my limiting beliefs didn't reach back that far. I actually just tapped into recently... what one of my limiting beliefs was. I actually have been married for 15 years, married to an amazing guy, amazing husband, amazing father. He has never taken his jersey off. He kind of jumped in the game and has played full out my entire marriage and in my children's life. My older two children are from a previous marriage that was 6 years. Completely devastating, low self-esteem, this whole bit. It was a wreck, actually. And I think I identified what a powerful man was through that first marriage. He was a very successful man, very on the go, go-getter, energetic a little bit, but as far as relationship-wise, as far as a father, it completely sucked. So I actually wrote down everything I wanted in a man, and it ended up being exactly the opposite of what I had first been married to. So I attracted this amazing man into my life in 1997. He took my 4 and 7-year-old up under his arms. He became their father. He was an amazing husband. And we went on to have another child, and she's 12, so our son is 24 today.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! And what happened during this marriage is my limiting belief was I was actually looking at him and sizing him up, I guess, to a man that was powerful and out and doing crazy energetic things like me. So I'm thinking that's what I needed in my life. So I completely downplayed him as far as a man would go. And I completely was looking, thinking I needed something more fun, more energetic, someone that sized up me, and realizing just through these amazing women talking to them that he is exactly what I need. He needs to be that person who grounds me. He is my rock, and I completely have, my whole life has opened up in front of me in just the last week, this limiting belief. What it has cost me, it cost me time in my marriage. It cost me time that I just didn't get to live full out, play out full out in some of my marriage with him, even though he was on the field playing full out. I was on the sidelines alive, hanging out, thinking I had it all going on, thinking, you know what, I'm powerful and you're sitting over here in the corner and what are you doing? Not realizing he's there holding for me, creating this huge container for me to be this amazing woman, and I completely just threw it to the side. And so I just was like, wow, my whole life passed by me, and I'm like, here I am right here with this amazing man who's still here holding me. So my transformed belief is in one simple sentence, I am going to be the queen and allow my king to take care of me. Woo!
I can't.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
I love
that
you.
Is
intense. I love you. And that
love
is great.
I love you.
Love you. It's amazing.
So powerful, Pam.
Thank you so much.
Oh. Full body chills.
That's You know, so often we forget that the people show up for us the way we need them to show up to be who we need to be in our life. And so sometimes we have it like they're not showing up the way I need you to show up, but it's not them that needs to change. Mm-hmm. It's us that needs to be willing and courageous to look at us.
Yes.
And see the king.
Mm-hmm.
See the king. See the king. Woo!
So the king. Amazing.
Amazing.
To the
wow.
queen who sees her.
That's right. Grateful.
Grateful.
Completely grateful.
I
know, we do.
I know. No, this is awesome. This is awesome. I'm super excited. And what's coming to me, and this is quite interesting, because I was raised with such limited resources, I was always afraid to make a decision. Every decision was something so magnified. It was like, Christy, you know, this decision is going to impact your life and so forth. And so I operated on fear instead of love. Every decision I made was fear-based. And so now at 35, I look back and I see how it's impacted so many things. And I had to be perfect. It needed to be right before I made a decision because this one decision would impact my life forever. And my mother always said to me, you know, Christy, the choices that you make are the choices you have to live with the rest of your life. Ooh, I was 7 years old. I'm thinking, oh my goodness, 7 years old. The choices you make are the ones that the impact, you know, the choices you make now, the ones you have to live with the rest of your life. Guess what? This kid never wanted to make a choice. And, you know, and in not making a choice, I made a choice. And that paralyzed me. And so a lot of decisions were based on that. And I took a huge leap, and I think about you when you said I took a risk on myself, and so I decided to do that, and I decided to make a decision, and that decision, I have to tell you, has had me in my bed in fetal position crying, terrified, like, oh my goodness, you know, but it has been the best thing that I've done for myself, for my life, really stepping up to show myself who I'm, what I'm made of and what I am. And the new belief is, I am whole, I'm complete, I am enough. And whatever happens, I can always correct and continue. I can always correct and continue. No decision is permanent unless I allow that to be permanent. Mm-hmm. And that has totally changed my life. Talk about courage, talk about risk taker. I feel completely unstoppable. So if there is any of you that feel that, you know, that are paralyzed because it needs to be right, I'm not enough, I need to know more, just go and just trust that everything falls into place. And if it doesn't, because sometimes it won't, that's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. That's
not
me.
That's
I love
me.
That.
And Christy, I want to acknowledge you for your share, because I think that what we tend to do as women a lot, especially powerful women, is we don't allow ourselves to forgive ourselves. Like, we beat ourselves up, we make a mistake, and we come
guilty or bad, or like, shoulda, coulda, woulda, and we should all over ourselves, and that is nothing for us, right? So I think that's amazing. I love your share so much.
Thank you. And I just want to piggyback on that and just say, I love how you said you didn't make a decision, and in not making a decision, you made a decision. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people need to know that. A lot of people are stuck in their lives in a holding position where they want to move forward, but they can't move forward. And they're thinking about holding on to whatever it is they're holding on to, but they're reaching forward to something else, but they're in a holding pattern, and they're stuck there. And not making that decision to move forward in your life, you're just making the decision to stay exactly mm-hmm. where you are. So I think you need to just be courageous and just step out on what you know you can do. Just like Chrissy said, it will always work out. And even when you think it doesn't, that right there is benefiting you in some way as well, too.
The waiting room.
The waiting room.
The waiting room.
Get out of the waiting room. Get out of the waiting room.
I put the quotes on it.
Yes.
I remember when you were in the waiting
room. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Took a risk on myself and jumped out of the waiting room.
Yes.
No. I can't.
Cannonball.
Cannonball.
Don't take a second to explain cannonball.
Yeah, yes, so please. I guess I'll go now. Cannonball is really a term that we came up with. I'll define it for you. It's actually hashtag cannonball. And it's an action, and it's like, when you're going to make a decision in life, we don't want to be the people that are toe dipping, like dipping their toes in the water. They're going to check it out. They're maybe not going to make a decision, or they might, you know, and they're kind of like half in, half out. And, you know, we were at a leadership conference, and this man was on stage saying that, and it just like came to me. He's like, I'm going to get in the water. I don't care how long I have to stay there. I don't care how cold it is. I don't care what I have to do until I'm successful. And I literally like wrote on my page in bold letters, time to go swimming, hashtag cannonball, synchronized swimmers. Like, I was like, finding Nemo. Like,
finding Nemo.
It hit me so clear, though. Like, we live one life. Why not play full out? And that's what cannonballing means, is playing full out. Decide what you want, cannonball. Let's go.
Cannonball.
Anyway, so my limiting belief. my limiting belief is that I have to do everything myself. And that no one else can do it as good as me, and that I have to do it fast, and it has to be perfect and hard, and everything's just aggressive and go, 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 conquer, conquer. Always on a conquest. And it's very lonely, and it's hard, and it's exhausting. And that's, you know, that's the cost that it has on me. And the other cost is that I don't let anyone help me. You know, and it's shown up in business, it's shown up in my, you know, romantic life, it's shown up in my family life. And it's pricey. And then when you hit that wall or you hit the bottom, it hurts and it's lonely. And so my transformation, it stems from my childhood when, you know, I was either hurt or, you know, disappointed over and over repeatedly. And it was really emotional. I was, you know, a pretty fiery little girl, if you can imagine. And so when things didn't go my way, it was like, not like go my way bratty, but it kind of was. But like it was disappointing, and I felt it really deep. And when things in my life now show up where if someone's disappointing me or not living up to an expectation of what I think they should be doing or how they should be performing, I'm 5 years old. My response to it, and it's really aggressive, hot. I like turn red, but it's not coming from an aggressive place. It's coming from a place of love, and like I want everyone to be okay, and I want this to work. But it comes across as like an aggressive, crazy person. And I feel like an aggressive, crazy person. So it wasn't working. And the transformation in that, though, is that I can trust people. And that I do love everyone. And that they are perfect just the way they are. How can I inspire them to be the best version of them? And how can I, you know, I don't want to say use them, but like make it efficient just the way that we are. Like if we're trying to build a bridge, none of us have to change. What do we bring to the table? And inside of that, I came up with a new hashtag.
You know your hashtag.
Hashtag love. Yes.
It's just hashtag I am trust. Ooh. And I trust myself, yes. And I'm the space for others to trust themselves, because if they trust themselves, I can trust them.
I just got full body chills, because that is kind of what I'm going through right now, with being open to allowing someone to come into my space and support me in expanding my business and trusting them and like really just allowing myself to relax into the space of receiving support. So like what you said, like I'm trust, that's huge with me. So yeah, I mean, and what that does cause me is not allow yourself to receive support. It just leaves you like high and dry. Like it is a lonely place, you know, and receiving support and building tribe, like this
yes.
is like
yes.
support to a T. This is a ridiculous amount of power in this room right now. And we're all supportive of one another. And it's amazing to be open to that and to receive support and give support. It's just the getting is in the giving.
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Heather, I love your story. When you say trust, I sort of feel like the letting go of control.
Yes. Totally.
And the letting go of control for me is huge.
Yeah.
And that kind of goes into my story a little bit as well, of my limiting belief. My limiting belief is not feeling like I can have it all. I grew up with my parents saying, you can do anything you want to achieve, which is great, right? Parents are like, oh, if you want to train professional athletes, go ahead, let's do that. But what they were saying was, but it comes at a cost. Mm. You have to work hard and you have to sacrifice in order to achieve it. So I grew up working hard my entire life to achieve my goal at all the costs. Relationships. So I went one track, let's do my career, let's do what I want to do, and all of a sudden, you know, my relationships suffer, the joy, the social life, everything like that. So when you say that, it's like you can have it all, but it's also giving up the control to be free. And so for my transformation, it's abundance flows effortlessly mm. in all aspects of my life. Mm-hmm. And that just sort of goes back to your control and trusting the process.
I want to actually comment on that. I had an amazing conversation with my mom, very wise, beautiful goddess in my life, last night, kind of about what I was going through, because this was very recent, and she was saying, you know, as powerful women, it's really important that not only are we in our drive and our building and our masculine energy, but when you feel the feminine energy, like I need to slow down, I need to take a nap, I need to take a bubble bath, I need to take some me time, do it. Because personally, what she was pointing out to me, which I didn't even realize, is that I'm just like override that emotional need. And I'm like, no, I'm going to conquer everything instead. And the cost that that has on us is that everything else in our life, you know, is really affected by what we're doing, including ourselves, our adrenal glands, our energy, our emotions, you know, how we feel as women, our sexuality, our sensuality, very, very affected. We're very delicate human beings. As hard as we want to be, you know, we really are delicate, and just taking care of ourselves is so huge, and it's something that I honestly haven't practiced, and I'm 30. So last night I took a bubble bath, I blasted Beyonce, I lit some candles, and loved myself. I mean, it was just like a deep breath, and it was beautiful. So I just really, really want to challenge all of you to take the time for yourself. That doesn't mean don't work hard. That means work hard and then take time off. And then work hard and then take time off. You'd be amazed what you can get done in a specified amount of time. Thank you, Monica. In a specified amount of time when you're literally taking, you're scheduling into your day, your downtime,
yes.
your me time, your Marissa time.
You're right? Giving yourself permission.
And we create time, space, and money for everything that's important to us.
Yep.
So if we declare, like, it's important for me to have moments to myself, yes. that time will show up for you.
Wow.
Instead of, like, I don't have time for myself, I don't have time for anything, and if you say that, it's going to be true.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's beautiful to create that time and space for you.
I was going to say, in the past, this is what I would say to this conversation. If I was watching that, I'd be like, oh, that's cute. Like, when I get there, I'll do all that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I make the money, when I'm making, you know, $50,000 a month or $10,000 a month or whatever that looks like, you know, I'm like, when I get there, I'll take a bubble bath every day, you know. And the thing is, though, and this is what I learned and through working with Monica and through just, it's like, it doesn't feel good when you get there if
right.
you cannot learn how to do it now.
Yeah,
right.
It's like, we have to practice this balance, this loving
mm-hmm.
ourselves now,
no,
every single
day,
so we can be present in the moment and we can be most effective, so then when we get there, it's an immense celebration, and it feels juicy, it feels like awesome, you know what I mean? Because I'm going to tell you right now, I've made, like I told you guys, this was my belief. I was like, I've made the money, I won the national championship, and I was like, great, what's next? When that's every little girl's dream. I wasn't present. I wasn't loving every moment of the journey. I was like, okay, tomorrow I have to do this. Tomorrow I have to do this. Well, what are we doing right now?
Mm-hmm. Like, I'm getting a manicure and pedicure tomorrow.
Oh, that's it.
It's been way too long.
I'm sitting here and I'm like exploding. Thank you so much.
You can come on
all
night.
I don't deserve it yet. I can't have that yet, and I do deserve it.
You deserve
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely, and we always get to say, I am here. I am now. Like, to really sit in the fact and the knowing and the belief that the destination is the journey, and we're never going to get it done. We're never going to really get there until we're like, peace out, Earth, go in heaven, or wherever it is that you believe you're going to go. So that's when you're done, you know, and we get to just...
Or not.
Whatever you believe. Whatever you believe is good for you. So, but you get to really just enjoy the journey, because if you're going to be happy when you get there, you will never get there. Because when you get the car, you get the money, you get the house and the wife and the whatever, then all of a sudden you're like, okay, so now what? You will never be fulfilled, because the void that you're experiencing is within yourself. So you get to fill that. And all this other stuff is just kind of like a byproduct of your happiness and what you're manifesting.
And my experience of that being here isn't necessarily this, like, Heather, we would always have this conversation, because so many, like we don't have that many powerful women role models in our way. Like, I'm talking, like, yes, Oprah, yes, all these women, but somebody that has a balanced life, a balanced marriage with kids, built an empire. You know, there are those women out there, but far and few between. So we get to be that. And it doesn't, balanced life does not have to look floaty and like.
That's what I was
like. Like, Heather's like, well, I want to build a business and it doesn't need to look like this. And I'm like, it's a blend.
It's a blend.
You can get stuff done and be present and like be efficient. But what I've noticed in doing this, and Tan, I'm sure you have a huge story and whatever on this, is that when you operate in that space, though, it's less go-get and more it comes to you.
Yes. Well,
and that's the feminine, that's the female businesswoman, that's the female empire that we get to create, is it comes to us. We don't have to chase. It's a different energy.
Because it's our way to be.
There's
teach
way of
me.
Yes.
Teach me to teach them.
I have an amazing friend. She's extraordinary, and she, when I was pregnant, so 10 months ago I had a baby, and when I was pregnant, you know, I was trying to balance and have everything work, and I was up to a lot of things and had that drive that you were talking about, Heather, and I was like, you know, I want to just have this baby, and I want it to just be open and free. You're gonna have it be open and free? How's that gonna work? So she said, you know, for your consideration, we each operate inside of the masculine and the feminine. So I love what you were saying, Jenna, is that inside of the masculine and feminine as well, when we're in masculine, it's critical because it's what has us do. It has the drive and it has the intention and it has the forward focus and it has sometimes even, you know, like we as women can have multitasking tendencies and shiny, sparkly things and follow them, you know, so it gives us that focus and that on purpose, on task. But when we do actually reside in the feminine, there's nothing to do. Mm-hmm. We fill and we fill and we fill and we fill, and then it brims right over and there's enough to go around for everybody.
Wow.
And there's so much that we never have to do anymore. It's just there, and all the need around us gets handled, and it doesn't cost us anything. And that's what entering the feminine truly is. So we can then have the resources, that fills us, then we have the resources to do the drive, go, 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 and we don't feel depleted at the end of the day.
Wow. Christy.
Yeah.
Well,
you
know what
I know
you
operate.
Right there.
Yeah.
Interest downloading from up there.
Tell us, Tan operates like that.
You do.
Woo!
Revelation.
I do. I pretty much, you know what? I'm a fisherman. I'm not a hunter. So I don't chase my prey and have them running around. I just pretty much, I be that I want to attract, and I throw my line in the water in a, I always hook them. They just come to me. And pretty much that's just how I operate. That's just how I pretty much operate. I've never been, even though I am powerful, even though I am loud sometimes, I've never been one to run. I'm actually very non-confrontational, which is amazing. People would think I'd be rah in people's face, but I'm kind of like chill,
yeah.
Kind of that way. I observe people, find out what people are doing, people see what they're up to, and then I kind of just kind of allow people to migrate to me. I put out there what I want. I focus on what I want. It's a big deal for me. I envision what I want to come, what I want to come into my life, whether it be for my children, my family, for my friends, for my business. I envision it. I clearly see it sometimes down to the smell, and I can smell the wood floors in the home that I want to get. And I just allow it to come to me, and it's amazing because I attract the people, the right amount of people at the right time. If those people that I think are supposed to be in my life don't show up, then I completely, I'm not connected to it, and I say that they weren't for this time, this place. I allow it to go. Goes where it goes. So pretty much, that's just how I operate. I just kind of submissive, really.
Hook and release.
Hook and release.
So uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I'm just so uncomfortable right now.
Why? Oh, good. You're not alone.
No, not uncomfortable. Because that was so amazing, and I want that.
But it's not. It's not something that comes overnight. It's a,
yeah,
it's
a muscle.
It's a muscle.
It's
a muscle.
It sounds very.
Transformation is something
you
practice every day. You can't. You will never really be transformed. So you can
invite.
What?
You can invite into you.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
And be open.
And be open.
And I want to say something. Do not beat yourself up if you are not there yet.
Yeah.
That's huge. Because I'm taking all this in. I'm thinking I was raised by a single, strong mother. So that's all that I know.
Mm-hmm.
That's all that I know. But that isn't all that I know.
Right. There's so much.
In the past.
Instant transformation right
that's
there.
That's right. You want to hear a limiting belief transformation? That was it. That was like that. That. You know?
Yeah.
Wow.
But then we get to choose. Mm-hmm. And that's where it really happens. That we get to choose.
Yes.
I just want to put that out there. We don't beat ourselves up if we're in that place just yet. That
we're growing.
Always growing.
Always
progression.
Growing
yeah.
Mm-hmm. And when you're emotionally intelligent, knowing how to make a shift and turn off that living belief inner dialogue that you, or it's like a downward spiral. It's like falling down the rabbit hole. It's like one negative thought leads to another and then another. Down you go, but then realizing how damaging it is and how it's not serving you, being able to turn it off and go right back up and acknowledge how amazing you are.
A few tricks that I learned, because this was all like crazy, like what to me, and like till I really started practicing every single morning, like spending time with myself for 5 minutes before I do anything, setting an intention for the day. And I think, honestly, practicing the muscle of hanging around powerful women and, like, being open to learning and, like, taking in new, like, we consistently have this women's empowerment group every Wednesday from 10 to 12, and it's being around this energy, working with these type of women, like, who you are who you surround yourself with. So I've taken it on to surround myself with people that are going to make me better every single day, and, like, I love learning, like, how can I be better? How can I? So, like, we're looking for people that want to be women's empowerment leaders in their community all around the United States, because we just want these people everywhere, and every single person has it inside them. They just get to find it.
Yes.
So, you want to share what we have going on this week, next week? And I want to piggyback off that, because I feel like in how long have we been doing our group? 8 months?
Yeah,
eight months. 8-9 months, I feel like the massive transformation that has happened just internally within me. Jenna used to speak, and I've done a lot of personal development, and I speak her language, but I never felt like I was that. And now it's like every day. It's like we are all a reflection of each other, and we're in each other's lives for a reason. And Monica said the other day, like when you see someone and you're like judging them for who they are right at that moment, like judge, I don't want to use judging, but you're like noticing who they are right then, and you're not thinking about how far they're willing to change or what they're willing to do. And that goes for yourself too in every moment of your life. You really get to be compassionate with yourself and be aware. Emotional intelligence is a muscle. and you get to be aware. So we have a lot of incredible stuff going on. This group is absolutely mind-blowing. We are making a massive impact in the world. And, you know, I want to encourage you guys to be a part of it. Come on this journey with us. We're going to broadcast live every Wednesday from 6 to 7 Pacific Standard Time, p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And we also have a Facebook group. We also have a fan page. So connect with the person that invited you to this broadcast. The Facebook group and page is We Change the World. And, you know, I really, really encourage you to be a part of this community. It's an online community. We post, you know, motivational stuff. We post what we're up to. I really want to challenge you guys to post your limiting belief and post your transformed belief and share with us. And it's really, I want it to be interactive. I want you to post and, like, know that we're going to get back to you and that we can play off of each other and we can learn and grow together. You guys are a huge part of this movement that we've created. So contact the person that invited you to this broadcast. Get on our Facebook group, We Change the World. Like the fan page. This is incredible, you guys. We're making a massive impact in the world, and it starts with you. It starts with your transformed beliefs. It starts with your I am statement. So hashtag We Change the World. Hashtag I am love. I am trust. I can keep going. Hashtag everything.
Next week's topic is who are you? What is your authentic expression? Who are you and what is your authentic expression? That's going to be awesome. I cannot wait for that. So like Heather said, get everybody you know on this broadcast. This is free empowerment to the world. Monica, since you brought this topic, do you want to put it to a close?
Sure.
Okay.
Yes. First of all, I actually want to give a shout out. So there's a woman, Nikki, who's part of, you know, our group of empowered women, and she's out in Okinawa, Japan. And she did her first ever women's empowerment group in Japan.
Yay!
And, you know, I just want to encourage everybody, just inviting people to participate with you, even if no one comes, but just having the courage and taking the risk to invite people to participate in something that you believe in, that you love, is such a beautiful step in really creating what it is that you believe in. And stepping into that transformed belief allows you to practice the muscle, not just with yourself, but always remember, in order to really have it grounded inside of you, you want to give it away. You want to pay it forward. Mm-hmm. So when we talk about We Change the World, we includes you. And every person that's watching, that's participating, and every person in your life energetically is connected to you in some way. So every small change, even if it's getting up 1 minute earlier every day, or opening your heart and paying back something to someone, or asking someone a question that causes them to have a smile on their face that they wouldn't otherwise have because you touched their life in that way, all those little minimal 3-millimeter changes make a massive impact in the world. And so often we take them for granted and don't realize that each one of those steps collectively changes the planet. So I just really invite you to know the impact that you have, however big or however small it is, and I invite you to keep sharing forward everything you're learning and know that the words and the truth that you are and owning that is what gives you permission to share with other people and give them their greatness.
Oh, I love that. Let's put up our cups. I am love. What are you?
I'm love too.
I am courage.
I am healed.
I am perfect.
I am inspired.
I am sexy.
Yes! Yes! Who are you?
This is actually really fun. So we have a social stream, so you guys can actually comment as we're speaking. And we have Nicole Ashley Model. I'm assuming that's Nicole Lakin, but I might be wrong. And she said, thank you for bringing that up, Christy. Muscle we have to work and be aware of that we want every day. My coach Suzanne is with me and we love this. And we want to hear from you guys. So during the broadcast, give us your comments, give us your questions on Facebook, give us your comments, feedback. We love hearing from you guys, and you guys are a part of this. You guys are as big of a part of this as we are. This is a community.
You
this
make
is a
this.
Tribe.
We make this.
We make this. We make this happen. We change the world.
Yeah. One, two, three.